Okay, so welcome back to my little mission to the moon in real solar system using a very, very accurate, if I do say so myself, Saturn V rocket with an Apollo command module and lander. Now, the lander doesn't look anything like the actual lander. So, but let's open up the fairing and do our business with it so that we can continue on our way to the moon. We've already used the third stage to boost our way to the moon, but now we have to extract the lander using the command module, and that means jettisoning. Now the real Apollo mission wouldn't have jettisoned these fairings like this, and it certainly wouldn't have let that go. But I have to do that in order to make this work. Now, there's nobody in the lander right now, so I'm going to have to do it all with the command module, and I'm going to have to first decouple this node. So that's going to be my target. And then I'm going to decouple this decoupler. Turn around. And RCS my way towards it. And it takes a lot of RCS these are still pretty heavy vehicles. You can see 30 tons for this command module. Get the custom window up here now. Now this little bit of a burn also changed my periapsis. You can see as I do all the maneuvering, there is a difference, and I have to fix that because I don't want to drift too far away from the moon. But for now, let's just make sure we can dock with the lander. And this is an easy docking maneuver to do. It's not like docking with two things that are in completely different orbits or anything like that. Alright, so let's, well, it should be fine. I'll transfer Jeb and Bill when we're closer to the moon. The command module is a little bit friendlier anyway. Alright, so we might as well remain oriented retrograde, because that's going to be... Well, it won't be retrograde with respect to the moon anyway, but it will allow us to use our RCS to perhaps get a better periapsis. And I can see the periapsis here, so I'm not going to switch to the map screen. So that doesn't seem to have as much of an effect as I would like. That doesn't seem particularly useful either. I think I might have to just settle for the fact that I'm not going to have very good periapsis going in. Problem is, again, I've got engine igniter, and you know, every time I want to start this rocket, I'm going to have to make sure that the fuel flow is stable, and that takes some effort. It takes some real effort now that we don't have any alleged rockets, and it's just RCS that makes the difference. Oh, this periapsis isn't our periapsis with respect to the moon, it's with respect to Kerbin. Okay. So I can't use that, I have to use this. All that little maneuvering probably threw me off more than helped me. Okay, I think I'll take anything within the 50-ish range, so 59 kilometers should be fine. Took a lot of hydrazine to do that, though. So, let me make sure we actually send some hydrazine back into the lander stage. I know I didn't fill it up completely, but it's not necessary. Alright, so RCS off. We have little solar panels just in case, so they're helping out the electric charge situation, but we've got plenty of electric charge. Hopefully it'll be enough with all the requirements that this has. Food and water, oxygen are good. Yep, let's head out to the moon. So, I guess I'll drop the custom info window for now. And, alright, zoom out a bit. And time warp. Departing Kerbin / Earth. We have a long way to go. We have a long way to go, and I don't know if my computer is going to hold up all the way. Yeah. So right around here is geostationary, geosync orbit. And we can't even really see the moon very well right now. I wonder where it is. Not that. Okay, so I'll see you once we reach the lunar sphere of influence. Okay. Here we are in lunar sphere of influence, and I should stop time warping. Our orbit isn't particularly wonderful here. Alright, well, I'm just going to go with that. At least in terms of direction, it should be alright. I still want to use hydrazine in order to do everything. Because, again, lighting the rocket is... Well, I mean, the service module rocket should be reasonable to light, but it's tricky actually. Especially because we're now not quite pointing prograde. It's easier when you're pointing prograde, I think. Let me just see how much effect. Wow, not much. Yeah, the hydrazine isn't really doing what I want it to do. I don't want to wait until I reach that maneuver node because it'll cost the full 100 and I don't want to pay that. Okay, see, there are a few ways to get this fuel flow stable, and one of them is just using centrifugal force, I think. So you spin around and you can get it very stable like that. But I haven't even activated the engine yet. It's actually in this stage, wow. Okay, we're not pointing the right way. It's all very dicey. Okay, well at least we've got it lit. Let's see. By the way, the service module rocket is actually using liquid fuel and oxidizer to light it instead of the hypergolic fuel. I don't know why that is, but I had to carry a little bit of liquid fuel and oxidizer in order to do that. The rest of the liquid fuel and oxidizer is actually part of the lander. Looks like even from here I have to do most of the burn. Okay, oh, okay, that's enough. RCS to correct that a bit. Actually, we can go into the outside view and do this. Let's get the custom info window back. Yeah. The moon has a very significant sphere of influence now. As you can see, we're still 60,000 kilometers out, and it's still able to grab us. Okay, that's close enough. There's the moon. And let's plot to get into orbit. No. Staying as a target is fine. What I really want, though, is a maneuver. Yes. Really has to be done at the periapsis. There's no room for wasting any more fuel. Okay, 55 by 45 is fine by me. I think they got into a roughly circular orbit around 50 kilometers. Or was it 50 nautical miles? I don't remember. meters per second, not a trivial burn at all. And we no longer see the correct delta V here because, well, first of all, we've got rockets pointing in opposite directions and all sorts of complications like that. This does burn the aerozine and N204 like the service module would have. Alright. Sorry it's in the dark, folks. So let me get this a little bit better. There we go. Yep, 18 hours. Let's see our approach. Let's see, can we get the moon and good lighting in the same frame? Nope. Alright, well, here we go. The moon is much more imposing now, as you can see. I think I'm gonna need at least... well, I'm gonna need some time. Let's see how our fuel situation is. Very unstable, of course. So let's try the same trick again. I'm going to just flip it around. And light it. This is not a trivial thing. I've had this fail on me. And even now it's dicey business. Obviously I did this a little bit sooner than I strictly had to. That's why I'm not throttled up. But better to do it early than make any mistakes with it. Well, we have an orbit. Yeah, but... well, actually, It's not quite showing it, even though we have an apoapsis here and the camera changed. We've used about a third of our food, water, and oxygen, which is fair. That's not bad at all. Hydrazine is a little bit of a worry, though. Remember, we have to dock back up, and that's why I'm... And actually, this might be a good time to transfer crew. I do have... obviously, the real Pal crew didn't EVA in order to transfer, so I do have crew manifest here. And so I'm going to transfer Jeb and Bill to the lander can. Update portraits. And so that's done. So they've moved on over through the tunnel. As they should. The lander does have lights. Just landing lights. You can sort of see how thin a veneer this orbit is going to be on the surface of the moon. It's very, very tight. And yes, that's how the orbit around the moon was. I hope it clears all the features of the moon. I don't think the height map of the moon has been changed to have enormous mountains. Let's hope not. One thing I've neglected to do is actually put either Kerbal Engineer or Mech Jeb onto the lander can, so that's a big miss on me. Next time I should really do that, just for the altitude reading, just to see the true altitude above the surface. This burn is probably costing me more than it should have, and that's worrying me a bit. And that's because I started burning early, because I was nervous about getting that rocket started. You can see our orbital velocity. It'll be about 1600, which is less than Kerbin, but still substantial. Obviously much more than the moon's 500 or so. And by moon, I mean the moon in regular KSP as opposed to our moon. Earth's moon. Now, whatever the situation, though, remember, after this burn, we're never going to have to use this rocket to burn with the lander. So it'll have much more delta V once we dump the lander. And of course, once the Jeb and Bill come back, they'll transfer to the command module, and then the lander can will be dumped. So we don't have to worry about boosting with the lander again. And so there'll be much more delta V available in that case. How much and whether it'll be enough to get back to Kerbin, I don't know. I've built this to spec, to the specs of the Apollo mission, but I'm not sure whether the way I conduct the mission will and you know, when I decide to restart things and how I use the RCS and all that, will really match what they did. Because I haven't looked into it into that kind of detail. Periapsis seems to be dropping. I don't really need that. Let me see which direction. Probably pointing up will help that. Let's point a little bit up. Yeah. Just try to get as circular orbit as possible. Probably not the most efficient thing to do, but it might help during rendezvous. Okay, well that's about as good as I can get. 40 by 87, not great, but that's because I started to burn too early. Alright, but that's another weight off my chest as far as just being able to light that properly and get it to burn and to getting into orbit. That's a huge thing. So here we are. And Jeb and Bill are in the lander can. Let's just verify. Yes. Our lander can needs to this is the lander cannon fuel tank, and let's just transfer the hydrazine. The hydrazine from the... yeah. So that the lander cannon can do the docking. I don't know if the lander cannon was the one that the lander module did the docking with the command module, or whether the command module took charge on that. I'm not sure. Alright, but here we are. And we're going into the dark side, so let's pass that and come around before we start making landing procedures, and maybe we'll aim for this crater here. Though I don't have any confidence at this point that I'll be actually able to hit anything. I'll just be glad if I get down safely. We're going very fast, and it is a very thin orbit. So I'm going to have to be exceedingly careful. If I do manage to land, it'll be the first time I have landed on the moon in the real solar system. So, yeah, I don't know if that's going to work out or not. Probably I need much more practice. So yeah, I'm just warning you ahead of time, Jeb and Bill are probably going to die. and I promise to, I will in that case revert flight and try over and over and over again and make a new video. Not every time I fail, but once I've got it down, I'm amazed I got this far, actually. And so the next step will be actually being able to land them properly and bring them back, and I'll have to do a lot more practice for that, since this right now is going to be my first time trying to do it properly. Okay, well, nothing for it. I think we've got all our resources, house, food and water and all that. Got about a day's worth. Can we actually transfer some of that across? Let's see. Let's transfer from this can to this. I'll give more food and take the wastewater and cover the outside out. That's not the only... I mean, 2 units would be enough for them for 1 day, but I've also got these on the side here. So let's find another module and do the same transfer. And then once they dock back up, I'll be able to transfer back any resources that I need to. Okay, well now they should be definitely well provisioned. Yeah, I mean now they have like 6 days worth, which is a lot. Certainly more than they really had. So, and Bob in the command module has more than 10 days worth, so. Much more, actually, there's some on the other side. Alright, let's do this.
No, but not.
Well, we definitely don't need both engines on the same stage, do we? This one is that one. Alright. And let's just activate it. You can see the thrust limiter limiting it to the actual thrust of the... well, at least somewhat approximating the actual thrust of the descent stage engine. It's actually more efficient than the real descent stage engine, so if I can't get this right, it's my fault. I've got the best engine I could ask for. Better engine than they had, so I'm going to get the landing gear out right now. Not that that will save me. Okay, so turn towards retrograde. Okay, well, it looks like we're safe for a burn. Let's see now. So let's say we were trying to hit this. Okay. Sounds like a plan. Now this one does not have the same kind of problems starting. Fuel flow is stable, and I don't think. These Kerbals, I tell you, always interrupting me. Anyway, it should remain stable. This is not one of those engine igniter is gonna give me trouble with. It will use I think it's hypergolic fuel that it uses to do the lighting though. Or maybe it's the liquid fuel. Alright. Jeb is thrilled. Okay. So here's the trick. When do I start my descent burn? I think I'm probably going to have to be very cautious about it, which means burning early rather than late. Let's get to 50k and then think about it. We're already descending pretty quickly. It's about 100 meters per second down. I don't have a good altitude reading obviously now, so a bit of a fail on my part there, not having Kerbal Engineer on this part, or Mech Jeb. Okay. Yeah, I mean, I don't see how there's too much time. Let's start. Maybe two-thirds power. It's a lot to bleed off. Another thing I had on the mech jeb that I really wanted here was time to impact, which probably would have saved me some guesswork. Huh. I'm gonna go full power. At least until I get to, like, lunar speeds, you know. Normally when we're landing on the moon in Kerbal Space Program, we're talking about 500 meters per second or less. There I think I have a sense of a benchmark, though of course the gravity here is much higher than that. Well, no, I mean, thrust to weight ratio-wise, it's not. It's still 2 Gs, but it's a different dynamic altogether. It's a different gravitational parameter, even though it's the same gravitational acceleration at the surface. I think I gotta come. I don't know where exactly the start of this crater is, actually. One flaw in the Saturn V rocket I've got is that the engine effects are horrible, right? They're just tiny little flames from those F1 engines. I want big flames. I want that thing to be a candle, but we don't really have that, nor any thundering roars. Sound effects and visual effects for that would be... would be great. I would love better effects there. Wow. Looks like going full power was definitely advisable. We're still going very fast as we drop. Kind of shade a little bit up, I think. I'm not worried about the fuel situation, though. I have no idea about the delta V of this lander. I just put the fuel that they said it had. But again, I don't know if the lander can is heavier than it's supposed to be, or something else is heavier than it's supposed to be, like the landing legs, perhaps. So I don't actually know if I have enough delta V or not, but it looks alright. It looks alright. And of course, if I was good at landing, I'm sure it would be fine. We seem to be getting awful close. I would think it's still pretty high, but yeah, not too sure. I'm glad I'm on full power here. Okay, I'm gonna kill the horizontal now. Okay. Well, at least we can take some comfort that we killed the horizontal velocity successfully, and that was a lot of it to get rid of. Now, perhaps even trickier part: managing fuel on the way down. How much of all this liquid fuel and oxidizer do we have? All right. Well, our landing lights aren't illuminating anything yet. But they can only illuminate... Would they only be able to illuminate in physics range? I don't know. Seems like fuel will be fine, as long as I don't do something stupid. Oh, I see our lights working. We're still pretty high. Ooh, wow. Okay. God. Okay, so, first time in real solar system setting down on the moon. Alright, I need to shut down this engine, because once we ignite the launcher stage, the ascent stage, I don't want it going up. And I'm gonna get the ascent stage engine at the same stage as that, so that's alright. Alright, extend the ladder. We don't have any other science-y stuff here. Oh, I probably should have tilt. No, the ladder tilt is fine. Oh, but it's not far enough. Oh, wonderful problems. All right, Jeb, EVA, please. Okay, hop down for me, Jeb. Whoa, typical. Oh, I bet Neil Armstrong did the same. All right, let's see now. The chatterer mod in EVA gives the breathing sound that you're hearing. And, well, what can we do? Let's just plant our flag, okay? Technically, you should have said one small step for Kerbal, one giant leap for Kerbal kind. On the flag, though, that's not what it said, right? This is so... I'm gonna say moon landing. Again, the breathing is not me, that's supposed to be Jeb, apparently. So what the plaque on the flags, below the flag says is, of course, we came in peace for all Kerbal kind. Right? And we have to do science while here, though it doesn't matter because this is not career mode, so, but, you know, whatever. Okay, you know what I have to do next. It might be a separate episode, it might be the same episode, I don't know how long this is going. Probably very long. It's a good thing I'm doing it on the weekend. Yeah. Oh, come on. Come on, Jeb, don't do this to me. Can't you just reach up and grab that? Well, first of all, you're a little bit ahead. Okay, grab. Okay, I pressed F. Don't mess around with me, Jeb. Alright. I didn't let Bill come out, but... this is just a test mission, really. Okay, so, if I've got this right... let's see if our... oh, wow, he's pretty far off. I'm not too sure if I can even get into an orbit that would suffice. He's that far off. I need him behind. But then, by the time it rotates, I might not be in a good inclination. I'm gonna have to have a very, very tight orbit around the moon to catch up with him. But at least the inclination will be right if I start now. If there's any sort of... I don't know if... because the moon is tidally locked, I know this. But I don't know what effect it will have on the orbit I have right now. Or not. Okay, well, yeah, I can't think of it right now. So let me just try and get up. And hope that I have enough fuel to fix it once we get up there.